Hi, I'm Jim Booker. Today we're going to get a chance to do a very interesting little thing with our brand new CX3 helicopter. Now this thing is really cool. We've got the MD-520N body on it. Very cool looking little helicopter, but you know what? There's a neat option for this helicopter. We're going to install it today and we're going to end up looking like this. Flashing lights. Now this is cool. Fly it in the dark. You can turn the lights on and off, but we're going to show you how to do this, a little how-to installation. Should only take a very few minutes, and it's not difficult either. Okay, I think we're ready to get started on our light installation how-to here. Let me say first of all, though, that even though I have totally disassembled this helicopter, you can install the lights without disassembling the fuselage from the components of the mechanics of the helicopter. It is much simpler, though, if you take the helicopter body away from the mechanics and start the installation. Now, I've got the light kit. First thing you do is fish the light kit through the body. Now, right off the bat, there are holes for these lights already in your CX3. They're already installed, so you don't have to worry about drilling any holes or working on anything. Now, it's a good idea to use some adhesive to hold the lights in place. Maybe they fit relatively snugly, but they're going to fall out. So I'm going to use a little hot glue. You could also use silicone rubber or just about any similar sort of adhesive. So let me put a drop of glue on here. Require a pair of pliers to push the light in, push it in place, hold it for a second. Next, we're going to install the two lights in the front. Now, I'm recommended that you run the lights down the right side of the fuselage. It only makes it a little bit simpler to hook it up to the radio when the mechanics are all reinstalled in the helicopter. Okay, we've got all four lights installed in the body. There's the white navigation light, the red light, and two on the back of the fuselage. Okay, I've completed the installation of the lights into the fuselage of the helicopter. Before I can test the lights for operation, I have to connect the power to the receiver. Now we're going to connect the light connector to the gear switch, which is the gear plug, which is channel 5 on the AR6100. Then I'll connect the battery power, the flight battery power, to the system. Transmitter is turned on and everything is working. So let's see if the lights are working. Oh yes, look at that. Now, with the remote light package that we've installed here, you can turn the lights on and off with the transmitter. You might also notice that I can stop the flashing and I can dim the lights. This is all using the standard E-flite transmitter that comes with the CX3. Okay, we can now reassemble the helicopter. We're going to put the mechanics back into the body. It's a little bit of a tight fit and you'll just have to work it in there, but it goes okay. You have to put the back end first, slide it around until the receiver and everything is in place. Now, at this point, check and make sure that the wiring is not going to interfere with any of the mechanics of the helicopter. Like right now, I've got one of the wires is interfering there. It's a good idea to put a little piece of scotch tape on the wire just to hold the wire in place against the fuselage side. And okay, so now we've got the mechanics back in there. Complete the body installation. Okay, let's continue on to complete the installation of the landing gear now. I had to remove the battery tray holder to remove the mechanics from the fuselage, so I'll have to reinstall that now. Okay, we're going to complete the landing gear installation now. One little hint that you might be interested in, I found that it's easier with all these tiny screws that we're dealing with to only unscrew the screws as far as you have to release them rather than completely take them out. As you can see, I left the four screws in the landing gear. This helps when I go to reassemble it. The screws will be in place. Okay, now we have the landing gear installed and we're ready to reinstall the rotors and connect everything back up. So we're almost done here. Okay, we've completed our light installation package and everything is ready to fly again. I think the rotors are going to turn. Oh yeah, lights are flashing and the remote is working. I can turn them on, turn them off, get some flash, not flash. Okay, we're complete here. We'll get a chance to fly this thing and see what these look like while it's cruising around in the atrium. Thank you.